Hello, Mr. Dreyer. Thank you for hosting the event. Very exciting thing.
We're happy to.
Very exciting thing, blockchain technique. Well, you as a CEO, one of the biggest banks in the Netherlands, what do you think of this new technique, of this whole new evolution?
Oh, I think blockchain will play a crucial role in the banking services of the future. At the same time, it's at the tilting point. We're all trying to figure out how it works, how we can make it work, and how you can get many parties connected on it. And that's still a discovery process. So it's a promising technology,
yeah.
But we're still discovering.
Yeah, because you have the public part, the public ledger, you have the private ledger.
Yeah.
And yeah, if it's a system for the inner works of a bank, well, I think it's a very fine technique, right?
It has all sorts of promises.
Yes.
It also had all sorts of challenges, but we're mostly trying to work it with our customers, so with partners in the chain, and that's where it has most promise. When you can do administrative stuff on a blockchain base, it has all sorts of possibilities and benefits.
Yeah, you're going to provide a new service, the WeTrade.
Yes.
It's a platform for entrepreneurs.
It's a platform where we connect 9 banks across Europe in 11 countries, and it helps customers, entrepreneurs, to export their goods to other countries. And so it connects customers of banks in 11 countries of Europe and provides a trusted base to do trade. You can do more trade with more trust.
And it's token-based, and 9 banks are working together.
They're working together on one platform. It's developed by IBM, the technology partner in this, and it's going live.
Yeah. How difficult is it to make all the banks work together in a technique that's still in a very early stage?
That is a part of blockchain that I think we're all still discovering. It's complicated because you have to agree one standard, and everybody has to agree it's open and not compete, and that takes a mental leap. And that's one of the things that we learn quite rapidly. That's an euphemism for it's reasonably hard.
Some people say blockchain is going to change the banking system. Well, that's very far-fetched, but as a CEO of a banking system, you got to be prepared for the future. That's a big challenge, right?
Well, I like this because it offers new possibilities to help our customers have a better life. And so we're all in it, heads first, but it's still a lot of challenges to solve before it starts to take over the financial sector. We see it as a great promise. We'll keep on investing in it, and we keep on learning.
Yeah, there is still a lot of need of regulations because it's very difficult to do an ICO in the Netherlands, providing a bank account. Do you have a lobby towards the Dutch government make this a little bit easier?
Well,
we're
in open conversation with the regulator to help them also see the promise, but also the complexities and how they can adopt it. We have, for example, one little idea in Rabobit where we want to explore how our customers, our private customers, whether they want a bank to help them on their cryptocurrency activities. And that makes the regulator highly nervous, and I can understand that. But we're talking with them in open dialogue, how can we make this trustworthy? And that's how we help our customers, so they will move along, I think.
Last question, what's your speech going to be on the stage?
Oh, I'm going to be reasonably humble that we're experimenting. We love this, and I'm going to show how we're experimenting with it, and I think it's going to be encouraging for all the people in the room.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.